Yeah, it's here in the Hump Show studio. Dig it! We're gonna have a real good time. Yeah. Me and the Chaser. Yeah. Morning Crunch. Monday, Wednesday, and Fridays. 7:45. Dig it! You're gonna be there and watch all.
Hump Show!
All at once, or you broke it up?
Well, no, that was all in one day, but I led up to it like 5 miles, six yeah. miles, 7 miles, 8 miles, and I remember that last day, it was like 9.2 miles, so I was tired.
You're doing 10 miles a day?
I got up to 10 miles a day.
Okay.
It's not something I want to sustain, it was just a goal to see if I could get there. It's time consuming too, right? Because I am running and walking.
Love it. She's doing the right thing. Sign a check for your host. Jigga style is love, X and O. Save all your accolades, just the dough. My game is wide, all names aside. Trying to stay alive, 100,000 for the bracelet. Foolish ain't out of chain to strain your eye. Twin platinum gun, son, ain't. Welcome to So High, the 420 Show, where we educate and advocate for the cannabis culture. We are your hosts, Biz and Cass.
Hello. Hey,
that's a good plan.
Yeah, that's the goal for right now. Still doing pierogies and all that stuff, too.
Nice. We'll dive into that. I definitely got some pierogi questions for you.
Nice. Yeah, we got some questions for you.
So, I wanted to learn the business of selling music. Well, Empire is the most forward thing that are all that happy all the time, right?
Displays for conventions and conferences, to home shows, parties, and DJ backdrops, Exponet USA provides the best pricing and service for all your print and branding and marketing needs. If you've got a guy, call Display J at 301-378-9363 or www.exponetusa.com. Also available on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram.
This is the Podcast Pit, brought to you by Ben Media.
So I was asked to flow straight on the Crunch Show. You know what time it is. It's time for me to go. I gotta go to work. Never been a jerk. You know what time it is.
What's happening, man? It's your host, Jamal Palmer, coming with I Am Recovery Podcast. This is my voice. Y'all about to hear me, and we about to do this thing. We're going to talk about real life stuff, real life situations, how you get through things, how you process things, and just let people hear us. So check it out. I Am Recovery Podcast, coming soon. Back.
The People's Podcast.
The Hub Show.
Hey, good morning, Hagerstown, Washington County, Maryland, America, the whole world. What's going on? Jay Heiss, Chad Smith.
It's your boy.
The Hub Show Morning Crunch.
Good morning, Hub City.
Good morning,
and
people. What's going on?
What is up this morning, bro?
Lots and lots, man.
It's hump day.
It is hump day.
Are you humping?
Not yet. give me a few.
Plan to?
I'll check in with you later. Let you know
what's
up. Yeah, all right.
Send video.
Happy humping. Anyway, hey, I went to do the early. I did the early voting Monday. You know, holy crap, there was a line out there, man.
Man, it was nuts.
People stepping up.
I went by yesterday to try to get it done, and it was like, you know, they have the people corral.
Yeah,
you know,
I know. I was corralled myself
on the side of the building.
The moving cattle.
Basically. So I had the bright idea. I said, you know what? I'm going to tap out. I'm going to go ahead and drop off Dana's ballot. And then I'm going to go ahead and come back tomorrow morning.
And do your own.
At 7 a.m. Right? I'm going to knock this thing out because nobody's up.
Okay.
At 7 a.m.
No.
I get there.
Bullshit.
It is as full as it was last night.
Yeah, man.
I was hot, son.
Yeah.
I was like, come on. Oh, I was so mad about that. But I'm happy to see.
How long did it take you?
I'm happy to see.
About an hour. It took me about a good full hour and a half.
I didn't do it yet. I'm going to try again maybe this afternoon.
I got corralled.
I'm going to need everybody to not vote at 2 p.m. today so I can go get my thing in. So if
everyone,
you hear me.
If you're not done by 1:30.
Thousands of our listeners out here, yeah. I want you to.
The millions.
The millions and millions. I need you guys to steer clear of the early voting center at 2 p.m. so
Chad Smith
I can go
here.
Get my thing in.
Part the ways.
Part the
Make
ways,
a hole.
Man. Yeah. You know,
you
I want that John Woo soundtrack. That,
John Woo.
You know, with the doves and the flames.
I don't have that, but
me
I do
I'm
have.
Walking.
Here comes Chad.
No.
Everyone parts the way.
You know, I come in like levitating.
I don't know why you get that theme song, but anyway.
2 o'clock. I will be at the early voting center on Virginia Avenue today. Do not be there. Clear the hell out, people.
Right, no kidding. I know.
You have all day.
So I got confused, as
about
I always
what?
Do. I never.
You
with,
know.
Never good with this stuff. So you and I, because of where we live in Washington County, but
yeah.
I live in Hagerstown. That's what it says in all the envelopes that come to my house with the bills on them, right? But we can't vote for the city people.
Yeah, we're not eligible.
I was given the ballot for the federal and the state, but now I was like, hey, where's
we are outside,
Emily Keller and the
we
rest
are
of them?
Actually just outside of Hagerstown.
Emily was
limits.
Out there. Takesha was out there. Tia Burnett's people were out there.
Yeah.
And they were all up in the face, you know?
Yeah, apparently we're out of bounds.
We're out of bounds, so we couldn't vote for...
can't do it, apparently.
All these wonderful guests
we
had.
I know, right? We had them on
After
here.
After all that.
I know, it's crazy.
You and I, of all people.
We can't even vote
for
them.
We can't chime in, man.
Jay and I discovered recently that we're actually neighbors, and
we
had no idea we're actually neighbors.
We borrowed some sugar already, a couple eggs. But
a couple of eggs.
You know, chuck them at each other.
Do people still borrow food?
No. I haven't had anyone do that yet. But, you know, that's an old school thing. But still, we are in Hagerstown, but we can't vote for mayor and everything else.
Well, hopefully as the annexation
Wait,
continues.
Wait, what are the limits, though? Where does it end?
Bro, I have no idea where the line is.
I mean, if you live near South High, are you in the city limits?
I don't even see like a sign where it says
Does anybody
city,
know
city
out
limits.
There?
Yeah, let us know where the line extends.
All I know is I tell where you're from. I say I'm from Hagerstown, Maryland. I never say anything else.
Like, if you're going towards St. James area.
Yeah, that's where we live, out there.
Yeah, I don't know. If you know where the line is, let me know.
Where does your phone tell you are? You ever get that on your phone?
No.
I'm in, what's it called? Fairplay?
Fairplay? No.
Fair something. I get that.
Really?
Like, I'm not in Hagerstown.
No, mine doesn't tell me that at all.
And then, you know. All and right. then we're like 2 steps away from Sharpsburg. Is that what it is?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, we're not far from
Sharpsburg.
But
I don't live in Sharpsburg. My bills don't go to Sharpsburg.
No, they go right to.
And I pay my water, my sewer, and all stuff.
Yeah.
My utilities. It's Hagerstown, Washington.
Yeah. Hagerstown, dog.
But we don't get a say.
Nope,
that's
we don't get
it,
a say.
Man. Fight the power.
What's wrong? Hey, the good news is, Jay, is that Phenom Fitness is soon to be grand reopened. Isn't that great?
Grand reopened.
How about that?
Grand are you doing reopened. A big? Are you doing a big?
Oh, it's going to be great, great.
You're going to go all out.
It's going to be the biggest. It's going to be the biggest you've ever seen.
Jeez. Just do them. Go back to the millions, dude.
The millions. No, listen, we're going to be reopening soon. I mean, we haven't been closed, but you know, we were closed during COVID. And but we rebranded. We moved.
But you also moved. Yeah.
Yeah, moved locations,
did
rebranded.
Some shuffling.
Yeah.
Took advantage
changed
of the downtime.
A lot of things. Yeah, focusing a lot on remote coaching.
Too,
and yeah, you did too.
See.
You
yeah.
moved too. Jeez. A lot of good things happened during the COVID closures.
The silver lining in all this is that we all have been given time.
Yep.
To do a lot of things.
Exactly.
And what you do with this time is on you. You know,
I'm hyped, man. So, you know, watch out for that. Maybe I can get busy to fire up a little bit for me. I don't know.
Hey,
maybe I can
get maybe a lot of favors lately.
No.
But
No.
That's all good.
I actually want to pay him.
That's cool.
I actually want to pay the man.
He's about to go to bed. He's probably listening right now.
He probably is. Yeah. Probably giving a good bed right now, you know? But speaking of businesses and
entrepreneurship. Yeah.
Do you like that smooth transition?
I did. I was right there with you.
This is why I'm a pro.
In stereo,
bro.
Man.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
We have a local entrepreneur here who's making big news nationally, which is, you know, it's a good stuff for I'm not really a hometown girl, but I guess she kind of is. She's kind of naturalized here. She's Hagerstown. She's Hagerstownized.
Hagerstownized.
Is that a word?
I think it is.
She's Hagerstownized.
I don't think I've been Hagerstownized yet.
Well,
it's been a couple years.
Yeah, she's kind of working in my space in the fitness field.
Really?
She's got a great brand coming up, getting some national eyes called Glamorina.
Yeah, Glamorina.
Yeah, Glamorina.
Do we got the right song playing here?
Yeah.
She got some theme music.
The one. Yeah,
she literally just gave this to us about 30 seconds ago. not your fault. It's ours. That's how we plan around here.
I love it. Well, I want to welcome to the show Miss Kia Phillips.
Yeah. Hang on. I got to crisscross my hands here.
Founder, CEO, motivator, inspiration, designer, all that stuff.
Hey.
Hey, maybe turn her mic up some,
bro. I am, man. Hey, I was listening to the theme music.
Yeah.
Ooh la la. You work out to this?
I do.
This is what you work out to?
Yeah.
In case you don't know, this is the mighty, mighty Run the Jewels.
Greg Nice.
Hottest rap group on the planet right now.
DJ Premier.
Yeah.
That's my man right there.
You don't know about that.
I know about DJ Premier?
You don't know about Premier. Stop playing.
Yeah, no idea, man. That's my man. All right.
Welcome, Kia.
Thank you.
Kia Phillips.
Yeah, we tried to have you on a little while ago. We had internet problems, but it's all solved, and here we are.
Yeah, it was embarrassing, but what are you going to do?
Exactly.
Just blame Bill Gates anyway.
Yeah, blame Bill.
Yeah.
Blame Antietam Cable. I don't know, maybe.
Somebody.
Anyway. So welcome to the show.
Thank you.
We've been wanting to have you on for a while. We noticed that you've been doing some big things out here in the world.
Yeah, we don't want to get in your way.
Yeah. No, it's cool, though. So
fit into your schedule.
Tell us a little bit about yourself, and tell us in case people don't know who he is.
Yeah, absolutely.
Elevator, go.
I am Kia Phillips. I'm co-founder and co-owner of Glamorina. Glamorina is the go-to activewear brand for culturally conscious women. So I created this line with my business partner, Nicole, in 2015. We launched our first collection in 2017, and we've been launching collection ever since.
Now, I hope Nicole doesn't feel like jilted not being here today.
No, I'm sure she's okay.
Okay, great. All right, good. You know, I don't want to cause any problems with you two,
No, we have a great relationship. So sometimes she does interviews, sometimes I do interviews, so it works out.
You share the load.
We do.
So it's a partnership.
It is.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yep,
so where is she this morning?
She's
in Frederick?
In the D.C. area.
She does some interviews over there, too?
Yeah, so that's kind of where we launched out, is out of D.C.
That's cool, man.
So how'd you come together for the project?
So I actually had Glamorina as a blog maybe back in 2013. Mm-hmm. I was covering local designers and artists in the DMV area.
Oh, so you've always been into fashion, huh?
I have. Yes, I have.
Nice.
So, you know, like I said, Glamorina was a blog back in the day. And then I took some time off. I had a baby. And then I decided to come back in around 2014 and decided, you know, I wanted to do something with Glamorina. So I knew Nicole through family. And I saw that she was an artist. She had like a painted shoe line. So I approached her about possibly selling her shoes on my site. And we decided, you know, let's do something bigger, something different. So the first thing we thought we were going to do is be an online boutique. We went up to New York and bought some clothes, and we thought we were going to resell those.
Do some Etsy stuff.
Yeah, and it just didn't really, it didn't work at all. It was a complete failure. It just wasn't organic. It wasn't, you know, authentic. So, you know, we scratched that and kind of went back to the books and decided, why not come up with this athletic line? You know, I'm a personal trainer. I would buy a lot of athletic clothes. And one thing that I noticed is that women of color were not represented in those images, the media images that I would see. So we decided that we would have this athletic line that was also culturally inspired.
So it includes a lot of like African prints and different things like that, really to showcase, you know, black women and women that look like us.
That's dope, man. Yeah. So, you know, how do you even begin a clothing line? It baffles me. How do you even start that?
It is a long process. Like I said, we came together in 2015. It wasn't until 2017 that we actually launched the first collection. So it took a good year and a half to really go through the process. So you start with designing, you come up with some sketches, some ideas, but the biggest and hardest thing is finding a manufacturer to really manufacture the pieces.
Okay,
And so one thing we realized very quickly is U.S. manufacturers are about 5 times more expensive than overseas.
It's crazy. Yes, it is.
Yeah. You know, we would like to stay in the U.S. However, it just wasn't financially feasible.
You go see the men of Asia. The great men of Asia.
Hey, I spent 6 years in the trenches of the apparel industry. I told you, I used to work for the Magic Show.
Did, huh? Yeah.
So I saw all of that in action. Yeah. Yep. I know exactly what she's talking about.
Yes, tough. So, you know, after some research, we found some manufacturers. And the next process is getting samples. And that's a long process in and of itself. Yep. The first couple manufacturers, we got the pieces, the samples back. They were horrible. They looked cheap. They just wasn't going to work. And you have to pay for all of these samples. Every single
batch.
Exactly. Wow. Whether you like them or not. And so after
you're just
we finally
money before you even make a dime.
Yes.
The apparel industry is no joke.
Yeah, it isn't.
Isn't it amazing before you go forward how much people don't understand about it?
Right.
All the clothes on that rack. Yes. You know what I mean?
Seeing it on the rack.
Yeah.
It's a lot of work.
It doesn't happen overnight.
Absolutely not.
So now you have your manufacturer. So you found the right. So are you working with an overseas manufacturer or did you find the American owned?
No, we have overseas manufacturer. Yeah.
And listen, you know, you got what you got to do. You know, I'm not really worried about that so much.
Yeah. Especially as a small business. We just didn't have the funds at the time.
Yeah. And you got to have the buying power to really like make it on America because it is very expensive.
It is.
Yep. Yeah.
Yeah.
So, absolutely. So you have your manufacturer now, you know, and you've launched the product.
Yeah.
Right. So, after you launched, what was the response?
So after we had the manufacturer and we got the samples, once we got the samples that we actually liked, we shoot those pieces so that obviously you have to have images before you launch a product. The website was already up, so that was great. So when we launched the first collection in 2017, it was an amazing response. It was clothing that you had not ever seen before with African print athletic wear. And so we got such a great, amazing response. We, you know, were featured to be in different interviews and podcasts and some magazines. And so honestly, Glamorina just pretty much took off from there. And like I said, every year after 2018, 2019, and now 2020 with this fourth collection, we've been able to launch a new line each year.
Wow, that's amazing.
It is amazing. Yeah.
So you're on your fourth collection now.
Yes, absolutely. This is called the Tribe Collection. I'm wearing some pieces right now.
I get it.
And yeah, we just launched in October 16th of this year.
Sweet.
Yeah, so a couple weeks ago.
So are you seeing good growth?
We are. Yes, absolutely. I mean, we had a pre-order season, and this has been our largest pre-order season to date. You know, many orders. We're almost sold out of a lot of pieces, and we just launched. So it's really doing amazing.
Well, you know, it seems like in the past couple of years, there seems to be a push for more cultural awareness and more cultural display. Have you seen an upswing in the sales, you know, due to the increase of that in the past couple of years?
Absolutely, especially this year. I mean, this year has been crazy, but definitely with all of the police brutality and the social unrest and just everything that has been happening with George Floyd, Ahmaud Arbery, Breonna Taylor, more recently, there's definitely been a shift. I mean, the narrative has always been there in terms of supporting black-owned businesses, but there's been a stronger, greater shift in terms of talking about what are we doing as a black community to support each other and support our own businesses and the importance of that. And so because of these things have happened, while we're saddened that they have happened, there's more of that conversation in terms of let's find some black-owned businesses that we can support.
That's pretty cool, man. That's really cool. So, you know, the partnership with you and Nicole, you know, you guys get along really well. So what do you feel like the secret of your success has been just as a partnership?
So
is it distance?
Yeah, right.
First off, a lot of people think that we were best friends, and we were not friends when we first you know met and came together. And did honestly, you butt heads? Yeah, I mean that's what a partnership is all about. we work very well together because we're so different.
Yeah.
Nicole's a little bit shy. I'm a little bit more talkative. She's better at the finances, where I just want to spend money, spend.
Hey,
so we balance each other out.
I know what you're talking about.
We definitely balance each other out.
I'm missing that balance. Been a crazy year. What are you gonna do?
Yeah, but I would say communication, just being open. The first year, you know, we would hold stuff inside because we didn't want to have any arguments. Yeah. Yes,
it's a relationship, huh?
Yeah, it is.
It's a marriage of sorts.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
So you have to talk about the good and the bad with each other. Yeah.
Yep, I definitely agree. So now, how's it been with the whole COVID thing? With the whole homeschool, because you're a mom.
Yes.
And school, you actually go to school like right here. You know, but the with having the kids home for a little while, because you have one, right?
Yes.
You have one. And, and how old is she?
She's six.
She's six.
Yeah.
Okay. First grade?
Kindergarten.
Yeah. She's doing kindergarten via Zoom.
No, she's here. She's in school now.
She's in here?
Yep.
Mm-hmm. In this building?
Yeah.
That was her we just heard? So,
some schools, you know, allow the kids to come back.
Yeah,
some
this is full of. You'll start hearing from some feet here soon.
Exactly. Yeah, we're going to hear them in a minute. Yeah. So,
which is cool.
Yeah.
So how did you manage?
Life.
Because I know the life of a personal trainer can be pretty crazy.
Right.
You know,
how do you know?
Obviously, you have some downtime. Obviously,
yeah.
You know, and you've got your little girl at home all day, and you're trying to, you know, have meetings about your clothing line. Maybe you know, you're trying to do all these things with that business. You know, how'd you manage it all?
Man, only by the grace of God. It was definitely difficult. So Nicole and I are both mothers of young daughters. Our daughters are actually cousins through their dads. So that's how we knew each other.
Oh, that's cool.
And so, yes, it was definitely difficult to have your kids at home trying to have a meeting. There were different interviews I was trying to do, and then you could hear my daughter crying in the background. So, you know, that's a bit embarrassing.
I think we're used to it now, though. It's like, man, I don't have any problem with crying kids in the background now. I'm like, you know, whatever.
Dogs barking.
It is what it is, right?
Yeah, but you just have to really learn how to, like, divide up your time, because especially younger kids need a lot of attention. The business needed attention. The business didn't go away just because COVID was happening.
Right.
So Glamorina still needed attention. So you still need to go out and make money, so we work. And so, yeah, it's just a matter of balancing our time between all of the different things that we had going on.
So what do you feel like you've learned, like, during that whole crazy COVID downtime? You know, what have you learned? Because I know for me, it gave me a lot of time to really, you know, think about my business, think about, you know, just a lot of things.
Time to overthink stuff, too,
and,
though.
Overthink.
A lot of doubt in here, man.
So, you know, did you learn anything about yourself, or did you come up with some, like, different ideas?
Mm-hmm.
You know, how did the downtime really affect you in a positive way?
Yeah, so I would say the first thing I realized is that I really have to take care of myself. A lot of people talk about self-care Sundays, but self-care is like every day. So one thing I started doing, I would wake up first thing listening to positive motivation. And I didn't used to listen to videos or tapes or anything like that. I thought that was like mumbo jumbo, but it actually really helped me stay positive. I don't know how other people took COVID, but in the beginning, it was rough. I was depressed.
It was a kick in the balls for everybody.
I think a lot of us were. We were uncertain.
Absolutely. You know,
I still kind of feel that too. Just not knowing
next spring holds for us. You know what I mean?
So like I said, with just all of like the police brutality and being stuck in the house, and it was definitely a lot of things that could can really knock you down. So I think trying to stay positive, listening to positive messages first thing in the morning, and then having moments throughout the day where I just went to my room and closed the door. So I had to give my daughter her cell phone for a few minutes so mommy could just take some deep breaths. So, yeah, I think one thing I really realized is just how important it is to take care of ourselves, to have a moment of quiet also during all of like the chaos, all of the news and the information that we're bombarded with
a lot
like
of
every
noise,
second
man.
Of the day.
It's been a noisy year.
Yeah, there's so much stuff coming at you at all times of the day. So right. much, and it's overwhelmingly negative too. It can really be easy to get caught in that swirl of just negativity.
Absolutely.
You know, and it can affect everything. It's crazy. Yeah. And the next thing you know, it's, you know, you've got this negative mindset. So who do you like to listen to in the morning? You have any favorites?
Besides
Jay and Chad?
Yeah, no kidding.
We are probably
we're
the
full
most
of motivation.
We're full of something.
We're full of something.
Yeah.
That's pretty positive too.
That's funny.
You start your day off with Jay and Chad, you have a good day,
yep,
I guarantee
that
it.
First, yes.
Guarantee it, or Jay will give you money back.
Yeah. So after you guys, I listened to Les Brown.
I love Les Brown. He's old school.
Yeah, I love.
He's
I
an OG.
Love everything that he talks about. Yeah. So I would say he's probably my number one that I listen to.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
You ever listen to, what's his name? Eric Thomas.
No.
Yeah, you got to go E.T.
Okay.
Yeah, go to YouTube like as soon as you get out of here and go check out some E.T., Eric Thomas.
Yeah.
Guy's amazing. Like he can inspire you to do whatever.
Yeah. You listen every day, Chad?
Every day, man.
You do? Like,
that's
you
why
wake,
I come in
wake,
here in such a good mood.
You wake up at 4:30-ish?
Nah, I'm up at about like 4:50, 5 a.m.
So, and then you put on the Eric Thomas? You put on the E.T.?
On the way in every
the
day, man.
Tonight?
Yeah.
Every day, I've got
that's your
Eric
that's your
Thomas
driving motivation,
or TD Jakes. I'll come in, you know. Yeah, I try to play it on the way in so that I'm ready to go the minute I touch down.
So you feel like if you don't listen to that on the way in, you'll be a different person when you walk in here?
I think so, man.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now
I
know.
I mean, but I don't even know because I've been doing it for so long.
He comes
years.
In here skipping, whistling, zippity doo dah. It's like, dude.
Literally, zippity doo dah. Literally.
Yeah, I mean, you know.
Yeah. Eric Thomas, because I like him because he's got this straight up, no nonsense style that's, you know, just like me. Mm-hmm. You know, I've been told that. I'm very straightforward.
Mm-hmm. EJ Fuller says he listens to Infinite Waters.
Infinite Waters? I never heard of that.
Never heard
Infinite
of that.
Waters.
That sounds like one of those sound effects things that puts you to sleep.
Infinite Waters, right?
Ocean noise?
Yeah, I use that.
That sounds like a sounds like a 90s cologne.
Flowing toilet.
For men. This is Infinite Waters by, you know.
Infinite Waters by Faberge.
By Carl Madden. I don't know. Infinite Waters.
Yeah.
You know. So
never
so,
runs out.
So where do you draw your inspiration from? Because you have some really cool designs too.
Yeah,
where do you draw your inspiration from when you're looking at these drawing boards?
Yeah. The first place is definitely just the people that I see in the gym. I take a look at, you know, I go to a lot of different types of gyms. So just see what people are wearing, what they're not wearing, and what they need. So, you know, one thing we notice, people need pockets, especially women.
Definitely
we need
pockets
everywhere.
Yeah.
When we're working out.
There's
pockets
no
on
pockets
phone.
On women's gear. Yeah. There's little change person.
How
in
many
back of the
pockets
pants.
Are on your pants?
I have three pockets on our pants, one on each leg, one in the back.
Pants.
We have pockets in our bra, one in the back for your cell phone, a little one in the front for like your keys,
a little pouch.
Pockets in our reversible jackets. So these jackets are reversible.
You're all about pockets.
Yeah, absolutely.
I got you.
And you can wear, we have deep pockets on each side. So, you know, I just take a look at, like I said, what people are wearing. One thing I notice a lot of girls are wearing, a lot of dark colors, gray, black.
Lots of
it's just
darks.
Boring.
Yeah,
it's
lots
boring
of
and depressing. I want to go to the gym and I need to be uplifted. So when I wear this jacket around Hagerstown, like this morning, I stopped to get coffee and the lady told me, "You make me feel happy. I love your outfit. It brightens up my day." And so that's kind of the goal. That's what we're looking for, especially with our bright patterns and colors for this collection.
Where'd you go for coffee today? Where'd you go?
I went to AT&T.
AT&T.
All right.
Gas station.
You know what?
Whatever, man.
Since we're live on the air.
I went to Keurig.
Since we're live on the air, I'm not gonna say anything about AT&T. Since we're live on the air. But, you know, I'm a little bit of a coffee snob, so you know I would
really Krispy Kreme.
Listen, this is good stuff right here, man. This is
I
the
told
glaze.
You I got Krispy Kreme.
And you know,
Keurig.
The only reason I get Krispy Kreme is why.
Because it's on the way in?
Because there's nobody else open aside from Starbucks.
That too.
Nearby at 6 a.m. There's no one else open.
I hate to be a Debbie Downer, but I don't know about the coffee situation in this building anymore, man. You know what I mean?
Well, you know what? Listen, I have an update on that.
What is it?
I went and I had some of the Charlie and Sam's blend. It was amazing.
Their blend is amazing.
Man, it's so
good. Different than what they were serving 2 weeks ago.
It's so good. It's like a lighter roast. Oh, it's so good.
I know.
It's really good, man. Shout out to Charlie and Sam's. They had they got that
upstairs here.
They got that blend right. That coffee is legit.
They're all about the cupcakes.
If you want a second cup, You can go upstairs and go to Saudi and Sam's. Tell them I sent you. I mean, I don't get any money for it, and they won't give you a discount. But, you know, it's good coffee.
Okay. I'll check them out.
No doubt.
So I'm looking at you at your outfit there.
Yes.
A lot of bright color. I get it. Beautiful. It's all good. Yeah. I understand, you know.
Thank you.
Hold on. Stand up 1 second. Let me see, because you have Africa.
She's tethered to the headphone. Hair. Look at that. Like, look at that.
The pants are cool. Look at the pants.
Wow.
That's our logo.
I like that.
Yeah.
Show that waistband, too.
I'm surprised Glamorina was available. That's a cool name. Aren't you surprised, too?
Yeah, I am surprised.
In the world of marketing and logos and branding.
Yep, absolutely. Yeah, like I said, I've had the name since like 2013.
Yeah, but still, so we've had it for did you believe the Hub Show was available? Even the website. I know. I was like, really? So, Glamorina.
Mm-hmm.
But
now
your pants are dark, but the top is bright.
One color. We actually have this pattern in pants, but we also offer black.
Trying to figure out a way to interview you and challenge you at the same time without, you know, coming off offensive or anything. So I'm going to tiptoeing around this here.
Oh, boy, here we go.
No, I'm just saying. I couldn't wear those colors. You know what I'm saying? Do you have a men's line?
We don't have a men's line.
Okay.
But we do have Caucasian customers that have purchased our stuff. I'm sure you do. If that's what you meant, you couldn't wear the colors.
No, I couldn't wear it because it wouldn't look good on me.
Okay.
It's kind of like the LA Lakers uniform. All the white players, that just doesn't look good. The yellow and purple, man. What? It's a fact.
Yeah, listen.
The black dudes can wear any color and make it look good. It just doesn't work if you're a ginger, especially, man. You know what I mean? Yeah.
Okay, a ginger. Uh-huh. All right.
Well, you know, you got red hair, you're wearing purple and yellow down below.
Probably not so much.
No.
Probably not.
You ever look at Ernie and Bert, those colors on their shirt? Nothing matches, Ernie, man.
No,
you
know, we're going to the Sesame Street now.
I'm just saying, man. It's all about the colors, man. Orange and purple. You know what I mean?
But following along that same line,
that's right. Steer the conversation.
We're staying right here. So, you know, it's kind of like have you gotten any, I don't know, I don't want to say pushback or any kind of like criticism based on the fact that, you know, you are celebrating African culture and African American culture.
Right.
Have you gotten any kind of like negative criticism about that?
Not recently. I think our very first collection, I had a couple of family members that was like, oh, don't make it too black.
Too black.
Too African.
What does that mean, though? Listen, we've been here before. I don't know how old you are. 35. Chad and I are in the same age range, but you go back 30 years ago, and there was a whole big push for Afrocentric. You know,
absolutely.
1989, 1990, it was huge. Living color.
Yeah,
and, I mean, everyone was wearing the African medallions. Cross colors, stuff. Cross colors came out. This isn't territory we haven't been in before. Mm-hmm. I guess it comes in waves or something. You know,
something like that.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, not a lot of pushback, but in terms of don't make it too black, really just don't alienate other consumers. And unfortunately, I don't understand when people think that if you're celebrating your own culture, that means that I don't like any other cultures.
Yeah.
It's not that.
Oh,
Like I said, it's just African-American women of color are highly underrepresented in the athletic market. Mm-hmm. You don't see a lot of images like us in their advertisements. And so instead of waiting for other big companies to provide that for us, we have to create that for ourselves.
Yeah.
And so that's exactly what we did. We decided, so when you see, you know, all of our images and advertisements, we have plus size, because our sizes go from extra small to 3X. So we have plus size women, because we come in different shapes and sizes. We have dark skin, light skin, what have you. Like, we're going to show that representation. We're going to show that diversity in our clothing, in our advertisements, because other people don't do that.
I was going to ask you about that, because I like on your website, you know, I was checking it out.
Okay.
I'll do my research.
He's stalking you.
You know. I mean, maybe.
I'm just joking. No, he did do his research, man.
I was checking it out. I'll do my research. And I do admire, I do like that you have lots of body types, you know, in your clothes.
Yes.
You know, and as somebody else has also kind of been underserved, or, you know, the plus size models.
Absolutely.
And, you know, if we're going to be honest, a lot of women who go to the gym who are plus size, I guess you call them. I mean, is that right?
What
plus
are you
size?
Supposed to say?
I guess like plus size. A lot of them, they feel, and I know you know this, they feel like they just want to hide.
Yeah.
You know, they don't want to be seen, you know, and they don't see a lot of people who look like them at the gym. So it's great to see that.
Really?
Yo, yeah, man. Yeah, yeah.
I go to Planet Fitness. I mean, I'm not complaining. People who are working on it, I take my hat off to them. You know, more. Uh-huh. If I see a big dude out jogging in my neighborhood. You know, I'm thinking, mm-hmm. more power to you, man. Keep it up.
Yeah,
you know what I mean?
Yeah, because I ain't jogging.
By all means. Well, I'm just saying, he's trying. You know what I mean? Making an effort. But absolutely. I see him at the Planet Fitness, you know?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Well, Planet Fitness, they've done a great job of being the accepting gym. You know, the no judgment. I mean, that's what they do. That's their no judgment.
Don't get me started, man. Yeah.
Yeah, no judgment zone.
No judgment. Then the next thing they're calling you a lunk on the next sign.
Yeah, but then they judge you.
People. All right. Anyway,
yeah, they're just shifting judgment.
I know.
They shift judgment. But it's good to see that you're getting all women represented in your clothing and in your marketing. Right. Yeah. So the now I know, you know, my girlfriend is a little on the
hang on, I'm gonna go to the website.
A little on the top heavier side, mm-hmm. if you will. And her
like 50
brand,
different ways to say it.
Her brand of choice on the bustier side. Her no, she wears a brand a sports bra called SheFit, which are made, you know, for like, you know, more top heavy women.
Yeah.
Right. So yeah. And they lock those things down.
Yeah.
Right. So so what are you doing as far as like the engineering of your of your sports bras? Like are you like how do they support?
Yeah.
If you will.
So we say these have medium support for everybody. And we have a lot of like focus groups. And when we get our samples, we have a lot of different size women, you know, try them on, test them, just to hopefully get better and better. You know, our first collection, we had sports bras and they were very little support. They came down too low.
Yeah.
They had kind of that cleavage popping out on the side. Mm. So these come lower down to the waist. They come up higher. The neckline is higher. Definitely cover more. And so we're just trying to, each collection, just trying to do better and better with people's critiques and, you know, just giving us their own ideas. We definitely reach out to our customers, to our consumers, and ask them, like, what are you guys looking for? What do you want? Now, I've heard a lot about SheFit. Mm-hmm. And I saw that, you know, they're one of the types of bras that zip up. And I've heard a lot of critiques about those that sometimes they might be, they got the straps. Uh-huh. Sometimes I've heard that the zips start to loosen up and they slide down. So I don't think there's like a perfect bra out there yet, but you know, Glamourine is definitely trying to get there each year.
Cool.
Absolutely.
I'm on the website right now looking at everything.
Isn't it good? It's good stuff, right?
Yeah, good stuff, man. The pattern you're wearing right now, is there a certain, does it represent anything in particular?
So this is called the Sahara. Okay. So we have two colors, the Nile and the Sahara. Obviously the Nile is, you know, it's more cool blue.
The more blue and yellow one I'm
right,
looking
exactly.
at here?
Okay. Just like the cool blue water of the Nile. And then the Sahara, you know, very warm colors, warm, bright, as the Sahara Desert.
And then you got the solids.
Exactly.
Which is all good.
Exactly.
I prefer that personally. For me.
Yeah, and so that's why it's the cool thing about.
I would look stupid wearing these patterns, man.
That's because you're boring. You know?
Yeah, that too.
But the cool thing about this collection, like I said, with the reversible jackets, you can have your bright days, or you can flip it over to the other side and wear it on the black side.
Is that what that is?
With
the
black leggings.
Cool. Okay. Oh, so the chick here, she's modeling the Glamourina cuffed knit beanie, and she's got the jacket, the solid black.
Exactly.
That's
you
the reverse
wear it on
of that?
The black side. Yep, it's got the logo.
On the what side? Say it again.
On the black side?
Yeah. All right. I'm down.
Just go black and don't go back.
Hey, now.
Watch out.
But you can. So you can, just depending on your mood. You know what I mean? If I want to wear bright leggings one day, I can. If not, I can stick on my black leggings. Mm-hmm. Definitely mix and match. Multifunctional.
Now, you've got some national eyeballs on your product, man.
We
you know,
do.
So what what publications have you had interviews with featured your lines?
Yeah, so we actually were just featured in Marie Claire magazine. Our collection is also sold on Essence. So for a lot of people that know Essence magazine, it's a top African-American magazine in the U.S., they create an online marketplace for black female entrepreneurs. So our collection is currently sold on Essence as well. And we've just been everywhere. Women's
Health. Look at the
bottom
of your homepage. There are Essences on there, Shape.
Yep.
Madame Noir.
Yep.
Heart and Soul. You guys were featured on Fox 5 out there in D.C.
Yes.
Nice, man.
Yeah, and so if you go on the website under the tab Us in the News, I have all of the links of everywhere we've been featured.
Come on,
We were recently on WKYS. Last Friday on the radio.
I do my research on the fly here, man.
So, we've been featured in a lot of publications, a lot of podcasts, a lot of magazines, Bella Magazine. I mean, it's just been wonderful.
That's a cool color. You got that one lady wearing the turquoise blue.
Yeah.
She's in the Sheen magazine here. Mm-hmm. There you go. Mm-hmm.
So what's next?
What are you hating about,
so
man?
What's next? are you should get it for your wife, man.
Why?
You should make a purchase like right now.
Absolutely.
This is you. on the spot. All right.
Hey, get that credit card out. Get the credit card out.
Yeah. You might miss it. We're selling out.
I'll tell you.
See? Come on, man. The pressure's on. So what's next for Glamorina? You know, like what's next level for you?
Man, so much. So, I mean, one of our goals is to be on QVC. We're hoping that will be the next move. And honestly, just continuing to make the brand great. We want to sell out this collection before the end of the year, come out with our next collection next year to be even bigger and better, and just keep rocking it. You know, we have 25 brand ambassadors. We have brand ambassadors all over the U.S., also in the United Kingdom, Japan, Canada.
Damn.
So we have lots of women that were
Japan.
Already.
Japan?
Yeah, we have a couple
people in
Japan.
Have you traveled? Where have you been?
I've been a few places, but I've never been to Japan.
Is Nicole doing all the...
No, so the brand.
No.
Okay. We haven't really been outside in terms of us
especially
traveling.
During COVID, yeah.
Yeah. It's more so these were previous customers that really just already loved the brand and wanted to represent, and then they get an opportunity to make some extra money. So I wanted to continue to develop that program, continue to mentor. We have a little mentoring group where we have some young girls that will come and help us like tag the clothes, bag the clothes. Any young women that are interested in having like a clothing line, we definitely want to mentor and share our experiences and show them how hard and how much work it is, but to encourage and motivate them. So, you know, mentorship, continue to grow the ambassador program, and just continuing to be great.
Speaking of the ambassador program, Dana used to sell LuLaRoe.
Okay.
So how do you feel about that model? Is that something that would be something that would be a fit for Glamorina?
I'm not 100% sure what their model is in terms of how they operate their brand ambassador program. But with our program, we offer a discount to the ambassadors. So they provide a discount to their friends, family, followers, and then they get a percentage of sales every time they sell something. So it's almost like having a little part-time job while you're just rocking your clothes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The LuLaRoe, now from what I understand from how it works, is they've got these limited like stock of certain patterns, and they have patterns. I think it comes out every quarter, I think. Okay. And they have these partners who they who, you know, they send random stuff to, right? And then they sell it.
Spit it out.
And then they sell it, and you know, it's like a small business. So they take these, and every distributor, I guess no one has the same stuff, apparently. Okay. So, you know, if you go to this person's sale at their house, or if you go to their live stream sale, they're showing what they have. Gotcha. This person over here will show what they have, you know, and they create their own little boutiques.
Okay.
So with these different patterns. So then you got these highly sought after patterns that you can't find anywhere else. And so that sort of thing.
Nice.
You
know what I mean? Yeah. I like that concept. That's definitely something that you can take into consideration.
Study it.
Let her let her run her business.
Study it and rip it off.
That's it.
Look, I'm trying to give her a winning formula.
Fair enough.
I like the idea of the ambassadors having like their own boutiques. That's something that I've considered. I don't know about the different patterns and things like that. That would take a lot in terms of a larger collection.
It definitely would.
Yeah. But I definitely love the idea of all of the ambassadors. I've seen some businesses that the ambassadors are like on Amazon and they have like their own little collection and stuff. So yeah, it's great ideas.
It is.
You know what? I'm full of ideas.
Thank you.
Lots of good ideas.
Even if it's somebody else's.
That's true.
Yeah. I'll let you have that.
Okay.
You know?
Thank you.
So outside of Glamorina, you know, we know that every really successful entrepreneur has multiple businesses, you know. Mm-hmm. So outside of Glamorina, I know you got something else cooking up here. So what else is cooking in that brain of yours?
Oh, man, so many different things.
Well, I bet. The hamster wheel's going there, man. Yep.
So outside of training, I'm a substitute teacher. You know, I used to be a preschool teacher, and now I'm a sub. So I'm doing that. And on the side, I'm doing a little bit of a reading program. So for the little kids that aren't on Zoom or are going to school, they're just chilling at home if their parents don't feel comfortable sending them to daycare. So I've set up a Zoom reading program where I read to little kids for about half an hour and do little puppets and things like that.
Aww.
So, you know, in my heart, I'd love children. So I'm definitely thinking of different types of programs and things I can do just working with kids outside of the business and everything else. Yeah.
That's Ooh. Awesome. So yeah. Kia love the kids.
I do.
She love the kids.
Yep. I've had a little some children's fitness programs. So in my daughter's gymnastics, I hosted some kids, like free kids fitness classes that they could do with their parents. Because not all parents can afford the gyms that have the daycares. Right. And then not all gyms have daycare. So I wanted to provide opportunity to get kids, you know, moving and also get their parents a little workout too.
Yeah, there you go.
That's good stuff. Like a mommy and me time kind of.
Absolutely, that's what it was called, mommy and me.
Look at that.
Yeah.
When you popped in here last week, and we talked a little bit about your history, you were a military brat.
Yes.
Okay. What branch? Army.
Army.
Okay.
Yes.
Is that you're from here?
I'm not from here.
Where were you?
I was born in West Virginia. It's hard when you ask a military brat.
I was where a military brat. I was a military brat and in the military, so I don't really have a place to call home. Where am I from?
At what age?
Exactly.
Where was I when this happened?
I don't know what I call home.
No. Did you move around a lot as a kid?
I did. Yeah, so I moved around a lot. But I went to middle school and high school here. I went to Smithsburg High. Shout out to Smithsburg.
So you kind of planted your feet here.
Somewhat, yeah.
I was the same way. Yeah. All right.
Yo, I used to hate Smithsburg when I was in high school because they had Fort Ritchie.
Yeah, we're talking right about there. That, right? All the athletes that's were military
that's
brats.
That's where I used to live.
Man, they used to import all these freaking like D1 high school athletes. I was like, man, I hate them cats.
Where were you stationed at?
So we were in Fort Ritchie. When we first moved to Maryland, we were stationed in Fort Ritchie. That's how we made it here. And then Fort Ritchie closed like a year or two after. I think we were only there for a couple years.
Really?
They closed. And then so a lot of those military families moved to Hagerstown, Frederick, Hagerstown, Smithsburg. Right, but
how about before that, though?
North Carolina.
Fort Bragg.
Yeah.
All right. Yeah. It's cool. I was waiting to hear she lived in Germany or something. You
know? I lived in Italy when I was a baby, but I don't remember.
I gotcha.
Yeah.
Okay.
My dad did live in Japan, though, in Okinawa.
Yeah. Okay.
That's dope, man. Yeah, I would love to go to Japan.
Yeah, man. Me too.
Go get me a PS5, you know?
Before for like $5.
I know. My kids are all, else gets all it. They're all jonesing for that right now, man.
I need that in my life.
I guess Burger King's giving away a PS5.
Really?
And I bought some Burger King today. My son's like, have the receipt. They're looking at something. They got to plug it into the lotto thing on Burger King and try to win a PS5. I'm like, what?
I'm trying to be like really, really sweet.
Yeah, I ate Burger King the other day. I broke a rule. It's once a month. Don't start. Fitness nuts over here. Hey, Jamal Palmer's on here, says to tell you what's up.
Oh, what's up, Jamal?
There he is. Yeah, I'll be producing his podcast in here soon, man. Yeah.
He needs to tell me about that.
There we go. But
all right.
EJ thinks that you would look great in some Glamorita patterns.
Hey, you never know.
Yeah, we might do like a whole fashion show starring Jay Heiss.
Catwalk in the Venue Media Studios.
On the catwalk. On the catwalk.
He knows that song well.
He
look
shakes
at
his little tush on the catwalk.
That's what he does at home, man.
Maybe.
That's funny. In the mirror.
When Miss Dana's not looking.
Never mind what I'm wearing. Never mind. Never mind. You just mind your business.
The secrets of Chad.
Handsome Jay Heiss. Hey, never mind that. Jeez, you know?
That's funny.
Well,
that's cool. So what do you do for fun besides like work out?
There's no time, is there?
There's no time, is there?
What's that? Hey, wait. You're a cell phone. You own your own business. I do. Yeah. She does. Fun is what is the 5 minutes you get to sit for a second.
Yeah.
A half hour out of my day, I read comic books. That's my fun.
I hear you, man.
Yeah.
I just fired up the old PS4 recently for the first time in months.
I can't do it, dude.
Probably since early this year, fired it up for the first time.
Hey, I haven't played video games in such a long time. It's because I know that if I start playing a game, I'm going to be there for hours. I ain't got time, man.
So that's why right now I don't play anything involved. I play just like Street Fighter. I'll play a couple of matches and be out. You know what I mean?
Really? You're good?
Yeah.
Not me. It's like a bag of chips. You only eat one, but the next thing you know, you're going to the whole bag. Yeah. I can't. I'll be sitting there for 4 hours.
So I watch The Real Housewives. That's my
What
fun.
City? What city?
All of them.
You watch all of them.
I love them all. Potomac's on right now.
Potomac, is that Maryland?
It is, yeah.
Oh, stop playing with
Real Housewives of Potomac.
Brown skin girls. Yeah.
I didn't know that. I didn't know we had our own show.
Yeah, we do.
Wow.
So now I got to watch.
Yeah, maybe that's what I'm missing here in Venue Media Studio. We need to start doing The Real Housewives, our own version of it.
Washington County.
Boy, that'd be some twisted
shit. Yo, don't laugh so hard. Come on,
I
man.
I love it. No, I'll be on
Real
it.
Housewives.
I'll be on it.
It'd be a live-action version of South Park.
You know what? We should produce it, Jay. Me and you. Sure. We should produce it.
Yeah.
We should totally do that. Totally. You find us some housewives who could give us some good content, and we'll produce it.
Yeah, I think it's a great idea. You don't even have to be a housewife.
Nah.
Nowadays, you don't even have to be a housewife to be
just
on the housewife.
Just the funny about level three crazy woman in Washington County.
That's your getaway? That's your escape?
That is. Housewife. Yeah, that's cool. My guilty pleasure. I love it.
Watch some flips from tables.
Yeah, just drama. Takes you out of your own self, we haven't right?
had that here yet.
We got somebody else fighting.
Huh, Chad?
Not yet. Yo, yeah, you won't let me.
What, flip the table? Well, I haven't had a guest like get up and walk out or anything.
No, nobody walked out yet.
I mean, I could say a million dumb things right now. She would do it, but I know better. You know what I mean? Yeah. So, hey.
Nah, she wouldn't walk out. Nah, she's a G. I can tell.
She'd throw a mic at me.
I can tell, you know? Yeah. I can tell.
I'm not on that level yet. Oh, okay. That level of celebrity where I could just, I'm done.
Yeah, yeah, you are.
Almost. Another year.
I know, right? So.
Another year and you'll be
that's
there.
That's how we go. Hey, that's how we go viral. It's, yep. Stuff exactly. like that has to happen.
Yeah.
Yeah, especially, you know. Given the dynamics in the room here, so
yeah, man,
yeah. Yeah. Knocking over palm trees and shit.
So okay. Now, the marketing. Let's talk a little bit of marketing. Talk a little bit about this. So, what are you finding is working really well for you right now with your brand?
Outside of, like I said, the ambassadors, because that's word of mouth.
Is that doing really well?
That's doing really well. This, okay. Like I said, we have 25. Our first year I had 3 ambassadors. Wow. So with them being spread out all over, that's great. And then obviously, I'm sorry, go ahead.
Shout out your top producer.
I would say Aisha in New York. She's all doing right. great. Aisha. Angela. Janae, yeah, Denise, you guys are doing awesome.
Wait, give me the names again. Austin. Aisha, who?
Aisha.
I know, I was thinking that in my head.
About yeah. 3 Kims.
I was doing that in my head. I ain't gonna do that on camera.
About 3 Kims. Start calling out like a DMX roll call, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Aisha, Shanisha, Karen, about 3 Kims. All right, let me stop.
Obviously, social media.
Yeah,
is great. You know, I personally am not a huge fan of social media.
I hate
but
it, man. It's such a chore.
Yeah, I actually deleted my Instagram page.
You did? I'm get done. Out of here, really?
Yeah.
Do you I don't find know if you it works?
The social media in terms of marketing.
How about Instagram? Do you find Instagram?
Yeah, it works for our business.
Okay,
it does. We can hit a lot of different markets.
Oh, so you dropped your personal
one?
Page.
Yes. Okay. Yeah.
Really?
I found
the business pages
seen.
Are harder to manage. I mean, Facebook, well, it wants
to. But see, I have a partner, too, so she does a lot of the posting and I stuff like that. I don't like getting on there. I get sucked into that rabbit hole. And
yeah,
it's just,
man.
It's, for me, not the best thing. Yeah. So, but it definitely has been amazing for Glam Arena. Yeah.
Do you got to do paid ads?
Sometimes. I mean, we haven't really done a lot. We've done a couple Facebook ads. Right now, we're working with iHeartRadio, and they're stuff. Doing an ad, a Facebook ad, okay. an Instagram ad for us. Yeah. So that's probably the top two. And then we do have a PR lady. Shout out to Camille Davis from Montage PR. So she's really been helping us. She helped us get on Good Day DC and a lot of other publications.
Now,
so.
Where's she out of? She out of DC?
Out of DC, yeah.
Oh, okay. That's cool,
yeah,
man.
Hey, Camille.
That's dope. So someone... Oh, Westfield's Facebook page?
That's my neighborhood.
Okay. Yeah, man.
I know what he's talking about.
Yeah, there we go. Yeah, that's good stuff.
Yeah, a bunch of nosy people, man.
Fountainhead, too. You got to go over to Fountainhead. You the North End crew is unreal. The North End wives are unreal.
The North End wives?
We do a whole show.
The Real Housewives of Fountainhead.
Of the North End of Hagerstown. You know?
Shows right there.
Look at that.
That's funny.
Then bring it together for a big fight, like once a year. You
You know, like a pay-per-view.
Forget the football game. We got cage fight, cage match, North versus South. Yeah, and to be all wearing your gear, you know, you'll be title boxing and Glam Arena. You know what I mean?
Title boxing. This guy is dying. Yeah. He's dying to get a boxing gym down here. He's dying. So what's your favorite fitness activity? So you know me. I just love lifting heavy weights. Like that's, I love doing heavy deadlifts. I love doing like strength training, nice. You know, secondary, like metabolic training, you know, doing like HIIT circuits or whatever, man.
Yeah.
I hate running.
You know, I know, I'm not a cardio fan either.
You know, what do you really enjoy?
I love running.
Do you? we're not going to get along.
You look like you love running. Seriously. I watched her walk in. I'm like, she's a track star.
Oh yeah, you look like a track athlete. Were you a track athlete?
Yeah, did you run track?
I tried in high school. I was not athletic. And that's funny because I'm 5'9", and people are like, oh, you play basketball. No, I can't dribble.
Yeah, you're built like an athlete. Yeah, you're built.
Yeah, you look like someone.
Yeah, my dad was a super athlete, and then it skipped me, and it went to my brother. So my younger brother is amazing.
Skip that thing.
Nope.
But now you're a fitness coach?
Yeah, I'm a personal trainer.
Personal trainer, like you just go from gym to gym. What do you?
No. I work at One Life. One Life.
Oh, I got you.
Yeah.
All right.
But yeah, I love running. I just love running outside my own time. Mm-hmm. I mean, especially when the weather is nice. I just, you know, I feel amazing afterward.
I tried to be a runner for a spring. It didn't take.
Spring?
Yeah, it didn't take. I bought my shoes. I was all ready to go, baby. I got my running shorts.
Trying to get your
mind into it, right? I tried to get my mind into it. I went to the CNO. Yeah. I went down to the canal. Nice flat.
One of those 5K runs or something.
Earthy run.
Yeah.
And no hills.
It didn't work.
It didn't take. Yeah. I hated every second of it.
Oh, no.
Yeah. You know, and they say once you get to 2 miles, you'll start to like it. You know, your body will adapt.
I've heard that too.
I got to like 2.5 miles. I said, I'm done.
Done.
Right. Yeah. I'm going back to the barbell.
Yeah, I'm the same way, man. I have to have a reason to run. You know what I mean?
Yeah, like, you know, like there's some like you know police behind me.
Yeah, some adrenaline.
Oh, like, then you got it.
I was in the army.
Some zombies. You know,
I was in the army. I did it. I did my running and all that stuff. While we were doing, it, I was like, you know, wasn't my thing,
running man. For me didn't take, man. I'm built for going really fast for a short distance.
Yeah,
and then rest.
Yeah, not like long distance running.
You do?
This is the best.
What's the longest you ran? Have you ran a marathon?
I haven't, but I would like to.
Wait, you like to go long distance running?
I do. I just like to run for, I mean, until I get tired.
Like Chad's saying, when you start running, is there a moment where you feel like quitting? And then you hit a certain threshold and all of a sudden it's down.
Yeah. No, it's the opposite for me. I start running and then you get like that second win.
Yeah, you get that.
But she didn't run track in high school or nothing. Like, listen to her. Hard to believe, right?
Yeah. It came later in life.
Cool. What's the longest you've ran? Like, what's the longest distance?
Do you do like 5Ks and all those things? You ever joined those?
I possibly have ran that far and just don't know. But no, I haven't done a marathon yet, but I would like to. Like a 5K probably.
She runs until she gets tired. Then she Ubers back home.
No.
Yeah. Uber. She takes a lift.
Yeah, I walk back home.
Walk back home. Yeah.
No. But yeah,
that's good stuff. Well, if people want to find out more about you, what's your website URL?
So the website is called glamourina.com, www.glamourina, glamourina.com.
Yeah. All right.
And you can find us on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram. Our handle is @ShopGlamourina.
@ShopGlamourina.
Because somebody had Glamourina already?
I think so.
I know. Yeah. But you got the website.
We do got the website. We're trademarked.
There you go. Yeah.
Yeah. Got all the legalities out the way.
Now, we'll have to talk a little more about that off air, about the whole trademark process.
Yeah, I went through it.
Did you?
I'm sure it was trademarked. I did it last year. It took a couple months, man. Yeah.
Okay. Because, you know, when I launched my Phenom Fuel supplement line, I may need to trademark some stuff.
I bet.
You know?
You should.
Yeah,
for sure. That should be the first thing you guys do if you have a business. If you have the logo, trademark that.
That's it.
Because someone can take it like that.
Like that. I already had somebody in Mexico hit me up about the Hub Show logo.
In Mexico, really?
Saying it looks similar to something down there. This is after I already went through the process and I'm done.
Yeah.
My trademark is legit. It's all good. I'm like, oh, I don't care. It's Mexico. I mean,
I don't care.
Hey,
that's international.
I know.
That's international.
I didn't even look at what he's talking about. I didn't want to know. I don't want to go down that rabbit hole. Whatever.
Right. Well, listen, thanks for coming on.
Yeah, man.
You know, I wish you all the
best. You're not leaving.
No. I'm not putting you out. Don't worry about it. Nah, I didn't call Uber for you. Don't worry about it. Nah, you're good. Nah, stick around for news.
You got some news? You ready to go?
Hang out. Yeah, let's do it.
All right. Here's Chad Smith.
All right, so 1 year older today, Dennis Franz from NYPD Blue. Remember that show?
I do, yeah.
He is 76 years old today.
Man, they're getting 70s, up there.
Oh, and Andy, what was his name? Andy.
On the show?
Yeah, it was Andy something. Yeah. I can't remember.
Andy Old.
Anyway. I remember the one episode where it was a big deal. They showed his butt. Remember that?
No, Chad. Yeah, that sticks out in your mind, doesn't
it? That was the first, like, bare butt. On TV, and it was Dennis Franz's bare butt. Like, of all the butts that they could have picked,
they showed his.
It was Dennis Franz. Crazy.
Stained your brain, huh,
you
Chad?
Know what I'm saying? Annie Sleepless Potts from Ghostbusters and Designer and Women is 68 years old today.
Who?
Annie Potts.
From Ghostbusters?
Nah, from remember, she was the secretary.
Oh, yeah.
Her.
Oh, was she?
She is 68 today.
Okay. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, she was also on Designing Women.
Ghostbusters, what do you want?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, yeah, with that horrible accent.
She's classic, man.
Oh, it was awful.
Yeah.
Daphne.
Scooby-Doo.
Daphne Zuniga.
Oh.
From Melrose Place. It's 58. Wasn't she? She was like that nerdy girl, right? With the glasses?
I guess. I didn't watch Melrose Place.
I think
Place.
She was.
That. You say Daphne, I think Scooby-Doo. So we're all good.
Listen, my girl was Velma.
Did they even have last names, though?
I don't think they did.
Okay.
Yeah, I don't
Scooby
think so.
Scooby did, but then
yeah,
it wasn't good. So.
Yeah, Scooby did. It was due. It was due. Lauren Holly from NCIS and Dumb and Dumber is 57 today.
Wow.
57 today. Wow. Andy Richter is 54. He's from the Conan O'Brien show, right? Andy
yeah.
Richter, yeah.
You're asking me?
He's 54. He's 54 today. Oh, I lost it. Get it back up here.
What happened? You lost your list of birthdays?
There we go. Not here.
A lot
here
of birthdays, man.
The famous Julia Roberts is 53 today. I thought she was older.
I think she is older. Someone did not like that answer, man.
Yeah, so she's 54 today. I'm 53 today.
Bullshit.
Yaquin Phoenix is 46 today of Joker fame.
What do you call him?
Yaquin, is it?
Joaquin?
Yeah, Joaquin.
You got me all confused.
Listen, yo.
Yaquin?
Don't call me out,
just
man.
Just call him Jack.
Yo, anyway. Jack. He's 46 today.
Yeah.
He's younger than me. Yeah. I thought he was older than me. Gwendolyn Christie from Game of Thrones and Star Wars is 42.
There you go.
Norman Gould and Luke Dumphy on Modern Family okay. is 22 today.
Wow.
Today is Champagne Day, baby.
Yeah.
Today is Champagne Day.
Wait, it's National Champagne Day? Champagne Day or what?
National Champagne Day. And ironically, it's also Chocolate Day. Champagne and
can,
chocolate.
That can mean
the
a lot of
day.
Things, man.
You know, it's Chocolate Day every day, Jay. You know what I'm saying? Every man. Day, Jay.
That's offensive.
Every day. Today is also World Plush Animal Lovers Day.
Jesus.
Plushy Day.
You, wait, where's yours?
Yeah, where is Funshine?
I think Tina took it.
Oh, she took Funshine?
Yeah, she went on vacation, took
oh,
it with her.
Oh, man. All right, so a new study finds that that 9 out of 10 $1 bills carry bacteria. That's news? Of
I know,
course.
That's gross.
You know, money
it?
Is filthy.
It's filthy, man.
Money has always been filthy.
Especially coins, man.
You know, well, I guess I won't be carrying those, especially the ones, but we won't say why they're the filthiest.
Yeah.
We won't say why. The ones that are filthy. So what's broken in your car that you've just lived with, Jay?
Broken?
Yeah, that you just said, you know, F it, I'm just not going
to
fix it.
Oh, I don't know. I guess my upholstery needs to be fixed, but, you know, I can wait.
Yeah, they can wait.
Ain't stopping
how about
the car
you?
From moving.
Anything yeah. in your car that's broken that you just, you know, yeah. don't care to fix?
The CD player.
The CD player?
Yeah.
But who uses that anymore, right? It's all
yeah,
auxiliary and...
My AC has been.
I don't have one of those.
Well, that's important,
car.
Chad.
Busted for like 2 years, bro. I just keep the windows down.
Oh, you're old school, Fred Flintstone.
Old
I like
school,
that.
Man.
You,
you know
all
exactly.
Right. Yeah.
You know, so well. Check this out. Put. Let's take it out. Let's check it out in the comments. Let us know if there's what's in your car that needs fixed that you just aren't gonna that you just aren't worried about.
Someone's gonna say tires.
Tires. You know what I'm saying?
I got it right.
I just Tokyo drift around town.
Yeah. Use his feet.
One of my windshield wipers used to be broke.
Oh, really?
On the driver's side. So when it rains, I just like look over to the other side and
try to change. Wait, the driver's
I did
side
that too.
The driver's side wiper wasn't working.
Yes.
I've so done that
the
too.
The other side was. So
I've done that too. Driving. Yeah.
Hey, man.
I've totally done that.
Hey, we gotta do what we gotta do, right?
You know what I'm saying? You ever be like too like be in a hurry to get somewhere and you get to
no
the car
time, yeah.
and your window is all
frosted or whatever,
up,
yeah.
And you just start heating up your car and you look at this little space
yep.
in the frost.
Everyone's yes. Yeah.
Son.
They got time.
They got time, man.
You gotta move.
So I don't know if you knew or not, but Kia, did you know that exercise can boost your mood for over 12 hours?
I
knew
she does
boost
know
your
that.
Mood. I did not know it was for over 12
for
hours.
For over 12 hours. When it comes to boosting your mood.
That's how long you run, right?
Research, research suggests that exercise is the gift that keeps on giving and giving and giving. So, in fact, the afterglow of a workout, can last far beyond the hour or so that has been previously assumed. Researchers from the University of Vermont Burlington said that moderate intensity aerobic exercise improves your mood immediately, and those improvements can last for up to 12 hours.
Yeah, I believe it.
See, one workout, folks,
one workout. No,
can adjust your attitude for 12 hours.
You do feel good after the workout. You accomplish something, man.
Yep. So how much a typical beer drinker will spend over a lifetime? How much do you feel like you spent in beer over your life?
I don't drink that much beer.
You don't drink that much,
do
you?
No, I drink beer, but I don't drink a lot.
No, what's your drink of choice? What are you into?
Me?
Yeah.
This is news, folks.
Champagne?
Tell us. Do tell.
Yes. We'll go with that one.
Oh, man, yeah, we'll go
with champagne.
Mimosas.
It's more classy. Yeah.
She's over here drinking Mad Dog.
She's got a Michelob Light.
Yeah, she's over here. You know, what's that nasty cognac that people like? What is that? Hennessy. I bet you're a Hennessy girl.
Hennessy, Big
nasty.
Chuck?
It's nasty.
Big Chuck drinks Hennessy.
Of course he does.
It's whole bars over there.
I know,
dude.
Yeah. I see it over here. He has every version possible. So if you are a frequent beer drinker, you'll spend close to $49,000 on beer over your lifetime. Isn't that crazy?
I just did it, man.
That's crazy.
People that come home with like big 12 packs and 24 packs.
Just 24 packs, 48 packs, and just have it going one weekend. One weekend.
One
you know?
One evening.
So, all right, can you guess? Let's see. Americans waste 17 hours a year looking for what?
Their socks.
You guess socks? What do you guess?
Keys.
Keys?
The cell phone?
Parking spaces. Oh. 17 hours a year are spent circling Walmart.
So stupid.
Find a parking space.
Park and walk, people.
Just park and walk.
Park and walk.
Yeah, get that 12-hour mood boost. Just walk.
We call it, in my family, we call it Maryland parking, because I've never seen so many people want to back their car into the parking space.
I don't understand that.
Since I've been here.
You're one of those? I hate that.
No one in California does like that.
Just pull in.
Just pull in.
You know, you're in the way, Kia.
It's so easy to leave.
Oh, absolutely. But still.
Kia, you're in the way.
Yeah, I call it Maryland parking.
That's exactly what it is, man. It's crazy.
I've never seen it
anywhere else. So are you going to take your daughter trick-or-treating?
No.
Why is she wearing a mask?
You scared?
Is that what it is?
I don't know. I don't know how I feel about it. She gets to dress up in school today,
because
though.
Of COVID?
I saw the teachers walking in. It was so funny. I was out here at 6:45. I was getting dropped off from coffee, you know, with a couple clients. And don't you worry about that. Don't you worry what I do in the off hours for extra money. So I saw this woman walking into the parking lot in a pirate outfit. I was like, walk of shame? Is she coming in late from a Halloween party?
She's disguised on the way home.
I was
home.
Like, that's funny. It's weird seeing a lady pirate. At 6:45 a.m. Then I realized she was a teacher and she's walking into the building. I was like, oh, okay, all right, great. You know,
this is the crazy part of town, is what I was told, man.
It is.
The first time I saw
the alley
crazy.
Behind here.
Yeah, it's nuts.
I've seen some things.
Pirates and everything.
I've seen some things. I'll just leave it at that.
Alley so pirates.
Last Halloween, a trick-or-treater came to a person's door. This is a story I found on Reddit, because I love Reddit. Okay. This is trick-or-treat stories. So a story was on Reddit. Last Halloween, a trick-or-treater came to my door dressed as Deadpool. Soon after I gave him some goodies, he returned for more and more. And I asked, aren't you the same Deadpool who left my doorstep a few minutes ago? He said, yeah, but now I'm the sequel. That kid's going places.
He is, man.
That kid's going places. That
or
was
it could have
genius.
Been 16 kids wearing the same costume, right?
It could have been, because I guarantee there's going to be 48 Deadpools per hour.
Yeah, right.
And then like 28 Harley Quinns.
Yep.
Ladies, stop letting your daughter dress up as Harley Quinn.
Yeah. No.
Stop that right now. She is not a role model. Stop that right now. So here's, check this out. So, You ever get the excuse when people don't want to come to the gym? I don't have time. You ever get that excuse?
Absolutely.
I make it too.
Yeah, I know you do. I hope you say it. You know? So we've got free time to exercise, but we choose screen time instead. When confronted about neglecting physical fitness, many Americans blame their busy schedules, demanding jobs and family responsibilities as reasons, aka excuses, why they can't seem to make it to the gym on a regular basis. Well, according to a study by the RAND Corporation, the average American actually has about 5 hours of free time each and every day. Mm-hmm. So,
based on what? Their screen time?
Yeah, based on screen time, the amount of time spent behind screens. You have 5 hours.
I can argue
a
with
day.
That, though. But
on average, well, I'm just saying, this is average. On average. So, what's really taking up your time? You probably know already. We also know from Nielsen research that the average American watches about 30 hours a week of television. Mm-hmm. Average.
She only watches one show. Yeah, that's like four versions of it.
Yeah, four versions of it. So people, with no commercials. You have time. It's official. No matter how you try to cut it, you have time. Mm. Work your butt. Move your body. Get yourself in shape.
Yes.
Make yourself more COVID resilient.
Get in or shape. Do your screen time while you're exercising.
Listen, that's what I do.
I do too.
Yeah, yeah, for sure. Well, when I was, whenever, you know, I do cardio, I turn on some YouTube videos.
I'm on it all day long. I'm answering emails and everything, man.
Yeah, you know, you can do it all by voice now, too.
Taking phone calls.
And finally, in the unnecessary research department, men look at women's bodies more than their faces.
Oh, really?
No.
Wait, hold on. Wait a second.
No way.
Wait a second.
Breaking news.
Breaking news. Exactly. So... a study found that men look at women's bodies more than they look at their faces. They also found that women do it too.
At women or men?
Let's see. As in women check out other women's bodies.
Yeah, I bet.
True that.
That's true.
This is the only reason mirrored sunglasses were invented, by the way.
Oh, because of women?
So we can't be caught
really
looking.
Not really the reason.
So they can't be caught looking.
I won't go there.
So we can't be caught looking, right? I saw a funny YouTube video where this curvy Instagram model actually she put a camera like on her back,
mm-hmm.
And to see how many dudes were checking her out from behind. It was so funny. It was so funny. Every dude passed got one of these.
Hey. If you got it, man.
Every time. Like, she had a camera right on her back to see how many dudes were checking her out.
Man, that's a whole other episode.
Oh, it was so funny.
Conversation we had with women laughing in the room, though.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the whole male-female dynamic and all that stuff.
Next time you come on, we'll talk about that.
She'll be on again.
Yeah.
She'll have a good
time. About being checked out at the gym.
Oh, God. That's a whole nother topic. Yes.
Uh-huh.
At work, while I'm working.
While you're working.
I've gotten whistles.
Whistles?
Really? Whistles? Yes.
Who whistles anymore?
I had to report this guy.
In a construction site? Who whistles anymore?
Mm-hmm. In the gym?
Yes.
That's some...
People will purposely work out on a certain machine that you're training your client, like near your area, just to watch you guys.
Look, wow. I ain't gonna lie, I'm not blind. I know what's there. I can see it, you know, corner of the eye and all that. But I don't make it a point to sit there.
Guys, don't be that guy.
No, don't be
Please,
that guy.
Please, don't be that gym creep. Because they're talking about you behind your back.
Yeah.
You are labeled the gym creep, and you will get no play from any woman in that gym.
Yeah. Like you're going to hit on her while she's on the treadmill, you know? Like, that's going to happen.
No.
I love your form, you know? What are you going to do?
Hey, I love your form.
Running next to her.
How you doing?
I know. Is that even going to work?
No, don't do it.
No. That's so gross.
I would
stop in the
machine. You're in a personal zone. You're working out, right. You know? Yeah.
Right. Listen. Do what a respectable man would do and jump under a DM immediately after your workout.
Yeah, right.
Listen, that's respectable. Find them on social media, jump in their DMs. They love that. Women love that.
That is a cool episode to have, though. We can bring some chicks in here and talk about that.
Oh, they'd be great.
I want to hear women. I've been wanting to do this on the Hub Show forever. I want girls to check in, women check in, and tell us like the funniest or worst pickup lines you've heard. Nice. And
we can do a whole show on that for sure.
It's a horror story, isn't it?
Yeah, we'll have you on our panel.
Yes, please.
I mean, just to put it out there, let people know what is and isn't, you know?
Exactly. Listen, we need help out here, man. We need help out here in these streets.
Yeah.
Because from what I hear, we're doing it all wrong.
Yeah.
Right?
We're doing it all wrong.
Piece of advice, if
a
female blocks you, please don't create another page and then hit her up again. It's the same picture. You're the same person. I know who you are.
Can you help us put this show together? That'd be a good show.
That'd be great. That's
a very universal topic.
Awesome. Exactly.
Yeah.
All right. So that's it for us, man.
Thank you, Chad Smith.
Boom.
Now, Kia with the weather.
It's cold.
It's cold. Hang on, man. I got a lineup for stuff here. We
line it up, man.
You
let's
got
send
places
her
to go. She got places
yeah,
to
let's
go.
Send her out.
We got places to go. And hey. There it is again. Thank you, Kia, for coming on.
Thank you for having me.
We appreciate you, and best of luck
to
everyone.
It was our pleasure.
You guys are doing. You guys are rocking it. I don't tell you best of luck. So I mean, it's all good.
Just keep doing what you're doing, man. Yeah. Keep it up. We love it.
Yeah, but don't be a stranger. Like, share, all that good stuff. We appreciate it. You know, we're trying hard here. You know, but hey, there you go. Ooh la la. All right, Jay Heiss, Chad Smith, Kia Phillips. We are out of here. The Hub Show Morning Crunch. Take care. We'll see you Friday.
Peace.
Peace.